Evening, everyone. This is a late night video. It's 9:47. I don't know why I just looked at my alarm clock when I could just look at my computer screen. Yes. So I just finished Christopher's Diary, Secrets of Foxworth by V.C. Andrews. Well, technically it's not by V.C. Andrews. It's by the people who now currently own the rights to her books and stories. Because she's technically dead now. Like, she started writing her books in, like, the 70s? Something like that, I think. Well, this story, like, her first story is actually based in, like, 1956. So, she's been dead a while. but this, like, okay. So, I've stopped reading the books that were published by under her name. Since I didn't read Broken Wings, but I did read the Gemini trilogy because I already had Celeste, which is the first book in the Gemini series. So, don't worry, I will have all of these at the end of this video and in the doobly-doo below. So, don't worry, I will have it all written down. And if you borrow this book, it does have the list of all the series of books that V.C. Andrews has written. Like, all the original stories are on this page. And then all the books that are new to her last name are on this side. So, if you get one of her books, it will have all under there. Okay. So I just finished this, and I probably should have stopped reading it until the morning, but I didn't. But anyway, this book was really good, but it was weird because there was like two long chapters, and then one freaking long chapter, and then a really extremely short epilogue. It's printed weird. So, like, the chapters are extremely weird. It's not even chapters, they're, like, parts. It's just really weird. But the content and the actual story was really interesting, and it pulled me right in. And while reading it, it makes me want to read the first five books of The Flowers in the Attic. This is, this book starts in present day, but Christopher's diary is in his point of view, whereas the first four books are in Kathy, his younger sister's point of view, and the fifth one is in their grandmother's point of view. So, this book is set in present day, but the girl, who is a cousin descendant of the Foxworth family, which is his Christopher's family, she is reading Christopher's diary, which was written back in 1956. So, it makes me want to read the original Flowers in the Attic series. It's just that good. I can't say much more. Like, I can't really say anything because the only part that I really, really liked reading, I especially liked reading, was Christopher's part of the diary. And now we've only come up to the part where they've got, like, in Christopher's diary, they've gone through the summer and they've just started getting into fall. And apparently it's in, according to in here, it is halfway through Christopher's diary. And then the next book is Christopher's Diary, Echoes of Dahlenganger. Kristen, the heroine of our story, and it's in her point of view when it's present day. Her story isn't completely interesting, but the fact that she is a descendant of the Foxworth family, and, well, a descendant, not exactly a direct descendant of Christopher, I don't think so, because her mother is a cousin, as a second cousin to Christopher's grandfather, so. Yeah. It's hard for me to explain the connections or explain it well enough for everyone to understand. You kind of just have to read it and it's like, oh, okay, I'm understanding now. Her point of view is interesting in what she's going through when she starts reading Christopher's diary. It's interesting, but I found more interest when reading, like, Christopher's side of what was happening during their time in the attic. Now, I don't know if it's going to continue into, like, the other books, because Flowers in the Attic is when they are in the attic, and they eventually do leave the attic. And then the next three books are when they're out in the world. So I don't know if Christopher's diary is about their whole thing, because Christopher is with Kathy like their whole lives. But as far as I can tell, it's just going to be his time when he was kind of stuck in the attic for 3 years. So if you, like, it says right here, Flowers in the Attic wasn't the whole story. But it pretty much is, like, it's kind of a mirror to Kathy's story, except from Christopher's point of view and, like, a male's side of what's going on and how his feelings are happening. For any of you who, like, when Flowers in the Attic originally came out, I think you will like this because it is, like, kind of basically a continuation of the story, because it is talking about the Foxworth and Dahlinganger family. And, like, my aunt actually gave me the original two, Flowers in the Attic and Petals on the Wind. She gave me the original two books. My covers are torn and kind of old, and the pages are yellowish. I got started when I was... Well, when Kathy first goes to the attic, she's about 12, 13. Like, when she's just starting her teens, so... So it was a book that is good for that age group. And though I wasn't there at the time when it was first published, I fell in love with it so much that I started reading, like, her other books. And, like, the other books in kind of order of when the series came out. And I loved those too, which is why I basically have all of them. Like, see back there? All of these right here. And pretty much all of the books right here. Well, most of the books here. Like, I have one, two. And then a column right behind this one. That is all of V.C. Andrew books. And like I said, it's all the series here. So, the original first one, the Dahlinganger family series, the Castile, the Cutlers, the Landry, Logan, Orphan miniseries, Wildflower miniseries, Hudson family, Shooting Star series, De Beers series, the Gemini series. And she also does standalone ones, which are just right here. And I have the first standalone book that she ever wrote, which was Sweet Audrina, because it's like she wrote it like just after the Flowers in the Attic. Not Flowers in the Attic, but the Dahlinganger series. That's how it's ordered in, like, my books back there, and not in here. It's under the standalone books. And I don't know why they have, like, Christopher's diaries in its own thing, why it's not over here with the Dahlingangers, but whatever. I am going to put it with all of my Dahlinganger series, the five books that I have. So, as far as I know, Echoes of a Dahlinganger is not out yet, but because it says it's coming soon, and this was bought last year. It was bought October 2014. So, I don't know when this will be out, but I will find out just basically for myself, because I want to know at least. I definitely recommend reading this book if you read it when it originally came out, or if you stumbled upon it. I definitely will introduce, if I have a girl, I will definitely introduce my daughter to this. If not, I'll even introduce it to my son. Well, we'll see. I don't know how my son would feel about it if I had a son. I just hope I have two girls, because I would be more comfortable with girls. But if I have a boy, then I could easily talk to my aunts, because they both have boys. So yeah. This was a really good book. Even if some of it was a little strange. Like, it's not really strange, like, how her original books are, because they're just, like, shocking kind of books. Like, some of the stuff, I could not believe what happened. Like, to, like, girls that are just, like, 16 years old and, like, 13 years old. Stuff like that. Just, like, it's, oh my god, shocking. That didn't really happen here. And she does... I'm not gonna say much for that, but... And with Christopher's side, there's not much shocking stuff from his point of view. There was a lot more shocking stuff from Kathy's point of view. So. But you have to read it to, like, kind of understand what I'm talking about, where it's not as shocking as, like, the original, but it's still, like, it pulls you in, like, the original B.C. Andrew books that she wrote herself. So yes, definitely read this, and read Echoes of a Dollinghanger when it comes out, because I definitely will be, and I will definitely own this at some point. So yeah. That is my spiel on Secrets of Foxworth. Excuse me, I had a little burp. And so I'm back to reading The Patchwork Girl of Oz by L. Frank Baum, illustrated by John R. Neal. Yeah. Yes, I've hardly read anything because I've been reading library books. And as far as I know, I don't have any more library books to read. So, this is what I'm going to be reading. So, I am going to try and finish Mike and Molly Season 4. Because I am on the last disc, which means it should be like the last, excuse me, three... It's like I'm on the third disc of the box set I have from the library. And it has 6 episodes on it. No, maybe 8 episodes on it. And I'm hoping I should be finished it tonight. So I'm going to wrap this up and say goodnight, guys.
Like. So. Excuse me. And like my cover, the cover is like, this is a hardback, so it has a cover.
I'm kind of excited and a little tired. I need to calm down. But I can't because I'm so excited. So.
I'm gonna put it with my book collection, I'm gonna put it with, under. Behind all of my... Okay.
I'm gonna put it with all of my...